cloud in the beginning, we must say, yeah, cloud is something in the cloud, you know, it's something not for me. Actually, in the Netherlands, just to joke, it's a lot of cloudy, it's not sunny, it's a lot of clouds here, it rains a lot. But the thing is, the cloud is going to come there. It's so much flexible deployment and business model for you, not just to think about the hardware and the software and the maintenance. It just runs in the cloud. You just take that service and use it. It's very, very powerful. I don't want to run my email server at home. I just use, you know, one of the emails services that you have online. So much powerful, and you don't need to do all that work. Okay. So one of the things that we run in the cloud is our mobility server. Okay. So why is that? Because when you set up an app from a mobility, you just don't want to VPN, firewalls, all of that. So it's all through a mobility server. It's all taken care. You can install the mobility server also on premise, but then you have to open up firewalls, ports. You know, you have to be very conscious of what you do on your infrastructure. By doing it on the cloud, it's working automatically. So we believe in native experience. Okay, when I use an iPad, I just want to feel it. Okay, I want just to swipe things. You know, just use the device as it has been built for. Okay, the iPhone, the BlackBerry, the same thing. And of course, you know, where do you get the app? You will get the app from the familiar stores. It's not that there is some illegal store. Of course, it's that there is only one way to do it through Apple, is the iTunes store. Or the Android market, okay, or the BlackBerry world. So what works is you just browse, you go to the one of the markets, you will download the app, and you will connect to the mobility server through the cloud, and then based on your login, it will see which of the apps, mobility apps, you're gonna be entitled. So what you download is actually a container, and once you connect to the mobility, you will add in-app the application, like you have in-app purchases for newspaper, you know that you have in-app that you will get that those modules. So don't go today on the iTunes stores because it's not yet there, but we're working on it. I can show later. I have already one of the examples on iPad of the Pulse of the Twitter-alike UI. It's already available on the Pulse, but we have even more. What we have is what we call Road Warrior. Okay, so it's really the warrior on the road that goes to customers, and once we have all the data available for, you know, for whatever reason, for the customer data, and this could be our orders, you know, invoices, expenses, my things also, but also the ION Pulse, all the alerts, tasks, to-dos, does not only streams to that application, to workspace, but just to my mobile device. This is the version of the same Twitter application, Pulse application, but then on iPad. Okay, and you see we're working also not only to us just text, but to attach documents or pictures into that. So if something alerts, you may grab a picture of that situation in that moment. So I have a video, of course, to show mobility. So let's go ahead and see how it works. So concentrate again on the screen. So the first thing is, I just launched Road Warrior and I log in. Just standard login, runs out of the cloud. And I have two applications, I have Pulse and Accounts. Accounts is really the sales-oriented apps. I have my application that I have opened, touch sensitive, you know, native experience. I can go ahead and select, you know, background pictures that I have my camera roll, which is a native application in iPad. So I changed back to Info. Now I select Accounts application. The first thing is I use location-based services to say where I'm located. In this case, it's in Alpharetta, Georgia, is our headquarters. Okay. And now I can say, okay, I go ahead and search some customers. Okay. I just enter some keys. In this case, just E. And it will find out worldwide all where all these customers are located based on the address of the data. Okay? So I will zoom in some, by the way, by chance in the Netherlands and nearby Rotterdam almost. And I see the industry, it's applicable for this customer. I can go ahead and open up the tab and see some details. And I can drag and drop these icons and I see the orders applicable for these customers. And I can maybe look into detail. You see the native experience that you swipe? And I can even go and take a look at the invoices or opportunities in this case. Okay? And again, native experience. These are data, by the way, coming from your ERP. It's not so native from your ERP, it's an integrated through IAM. This is the pulse. So I can swipe that, I have all the full screen. Now I can move column like I have on pulse, just I have that. I can use all the filters. So I have the same filters I have on the desktop version, alerts, messages, tasks, notification, escalations. And I can even take on hand one of them and, you know, work from there. So I can do a task on the desktop version, continue on my iPad like I do email today. That data you saw in iPad on the accounts invoices, that comes from your business system. It's not just a platform, it's a different platform, working from more consumer-grade user experience and, you know, modern, fat-free middleware that works, you know, the way you want. So now I have a video.
We believe the basis for competition over the coming decades will be speed, not just scale. If you look at society, we're completely consumed with the notion of speed. Everything is about the immediacy of now. We felt you needed to build applications that allowed companies to compete on the basis of speed.
We aspire to accomplish three goals at Fortune. One, change the way work gets done by delivering a consumer-grade experience that allows users to work the way they love. Two, to complete the application for specific markets so that no customer requires modifications in order for their software to work for them. And three, reimagine the way enterprise software is managed in order to provide far more agility for customers with a much greater ability for them to innovate. Consumer grade means what you use at home. Look at Google, look at Twitter, Facebook, iTunes. Tremendous innovation has gone into those user experiences in the past 10 years, yet very few of those innovations have found their way into enterprise applications. Inform's changing that.
Because it doesn't have industry functionality they need, it doesn't have the localizations they need, it doesn't have integration among the applications, it doesn't support industry reporting out of the box. So we strove to deliver an application that's complete, that serves industries out of the box, so they can deploy faster and get to value faster.
What makes IAM so special is that it is built on an unbreakable architecture. When customers upgrade, integrations break, reporting breaks, extensions to applications tend to break. IAM is built on an architecture that makes these three things unbreakable.
We are taking that the last month to change the way work gets done.
To deliver complete industry suites.
To focus resources more exclusively on those industries.
The solution will implement faster, upgrade faster, and be responsive to the customer's core needs faster.
And that really is at the core of what Infor 10 is all about.